Get your daily news fix. I'm Ravel Gevan and Plus 61 News starts now.
Live from Cheerborn, this is Plushin 61 News.
This year, the whole world was shaken by the coronavirus. Every country in the world was obliged to lock down their citizens at home in order to break the chain of the virus transmission. Global economies were disrupted in both developing and even developed countries. This made recession inevitable to every country sooner or later. The Cambridge English Dictionary defines recession as a period of time when the economy of a country is not doing well. Industrial production and business activity are at low level, and there are many people unemployed. Well, according to Forbes, recession is a significant decrease in economic activities that lasts for months or even years. Recession can be seen when there is a disproportion between consumption and production, negative percentage of gross domestic product, and high amount of unemployment across the country. As a developing country, Indonesia in economic structure is supported by the domestic consumption, with the contribution of almost 60% of the output. Countries with high amount of population, such as Indonesia, has an advantage that minimizes the impact of global recession. Unfortunately, economics in Indonesia is still depending on commodities. Exporting contributes 20% to the gross domestic product in Indonesia. Well, more than 60% of Indonesia's exports are commodities that have no more contribution value. When global recession happens, the value of commodities will drop, and eventually domestic economy will be affected by the dropping of export rates. Even before the pandemic occurred in Indonesia, the growth of economy of Indonesia is only 2.97% in the first quarter of 2020. While in the second quarter of 2020, Indonesia's economic growth dropped by 5.32%, making it the second worst economic growth since the 1998 crisis. As for the third quarter, the Ministry of Economics projected the economic growth will be in the range of -1.1 to 0.2%. If the growth rate of GDP in Indonesia keeps growing negatively, Indonesia will enter recession and eventually rise unemployment rate because of enterprises that are turning their business down. The World Bank predicts the poverty rate in Indonesia will increase approximately 5.5 to 8 million people this year, according to Central Bureau of Statistics, or BPS. The number of poor citizens in Indonesia is 26.4 million people in March of 2020. This number represents 9.78% from the total population in Indonesia. This number has increased from 24.79 million in September of 2019. After the coronavirus crisis, it is predicted that the number will keep increasing, since after the pandemic occurred, more and more people are fired from their respective jobs. To face the inevitable recession, citizens are advised, be thrifty, use the salary that you have wisely. Keep saving your money so that you can use it when needed, said Peter Abdullah, the research director of Center of Reform of Economics. There are four things that can be done in order to avoid the impact of recession. First, prepare for urgent money. Second, cut off unnecessary transactions. Third, reduce the use of credit cards. And fourth, come up with a side business. That's it for today's news. I'm Ravel Gevan, signing off.
Live from Cheerborn, this is Plushin 61 News.